Subscribe to this channel to join Team Microcontrollers Hub.
User interface is one of the crucial features of any embedded project. Smart user interface can make your project look more appealing as well as easy to use for your customers. So for data input, we often use push buttons or rotary encoders, and for displaying data, we use 7-segment or 16x2 LCD displays. But sometimes these user interfaces are not sufficient. So in this video, we are going to see how we can add touch screen feature to our project. We will first understand basic functionality of these screens and then few interesting examples. Let's get started. Hello guys, Varad here from Microcontrollers Hub. This channel is about various DIY tutorials of embedded IoT projects and exploring different add-on modules for it. Today's video is about 2.8 inch TFT touchscreen. There are multiple manufacturers of this module, but the one I have is from Elgo. These screens are available in various communication interfaces like 4-line serial or 8, 16, 32-bit parallel interface. The one I have is much better as it has 8-bit parallel interface and it comes as an Arduino Shield module, so it becomes very easy for plug and play projects. Along the touchscreen, this shield also offers micro SD card slot which you can use to store images or sensor data. Now if you want to use any sensor module or touchscreen or any IC with its full potential, you should first go through its datasheet. The datasheet has all the solutions for the questions you have regarding that module. So the first thing we are going to check is basic specification. This is a 2.8 inch TFT LCD module. TFT stands for thin film transistor. That is, the display have a transistor for each pixel on the screen. The resolution of this display is 240 by 320 and supports red, green, blue colors. So practically you can make any color out of it. Which means we can also show colored images on this display. Now according to the power ratings, the input voltage must remain between 3.3 to 5.5 volts and current consumption is approx 120 mA. Here we can see the pinout of this module. As I'm gonna use either Arduino Uno or Mega, I just have to plug the module like this and use it. But if you are planning to use your custom board, make sure to do connection as per this table. Also, we can see that this module uses almost all pins of Arduino Uno except A5. So it is recommended to use with Arduino Mega to have extra IOs for other peripherals. Now in order to make this display work, we need to send the control signals to the display driver IC, which is ILI9341. This datasheet provides detailed explanation about the control signals for this display. If we go to command list, we can see how to change the bits to change the content on the display. It will take a huge time if we try to write code to control digital IOs for each and every command mentioned in this datasheet. Fortunately, we have a solution for this. The manufacturer has provided Arduino library, which reduces our workload and makes controlling this display very easy. Let's have a demo for it. So the first example you should try is obviously graphics test. For that, import the library and open the example for Elgo TFT graphics test. Check that your connections are as mentioned here, which is true in my case, so I will just click on upload to test my display. After upload is complete, we can see multiple test lines and design getting displayed on the screen. Isn't that cool? We'll go through step by step tutorial to draw this UI, which can be used to control an LED. Now let's have a look at the code. First, import the header file and define necessary macros. Then create the object of Elgo TFT LCD class. Then first thing to do is reset the LCD and initialize the LCD by command tft.begin0x9341. Then to change the background, use tft.fillScreenBlack. Obviously if you want a red colored background, then use fillScreenRed. But I will go with black. Then let's draw a green rectangle in upper half, which is done by tft.fillRect 0, 0, 240, 160, green. The arguments are x-coordinate, y-coordinate, width, height, and color, respectively. To draw a red rectangle below it, we will use tft.fillrect 0, 160, 240, 160, red. Fill rectangle is used to draw and fill rectangles, whereas draw rectangle will only draw the border of the rectangles. So let's draw white colored outline to these rectangles by these commands. Now we have our background ready, let's write some text on it. For that, first set the text color and text size. Then set the text cursor to desired location and use tft.println turn on. Similarly, we can write the text turn off. That's it. See how simple it is to control this display by using provided library. Now we have our display ready, let's see how to add touch functionality to it. For that, let's first include the touch screen header file to our code. Then define minimum and maximum values for the x and y axis and create the object of the class touchScreen. Then in while loop, let's first read the touch coordinates and check the pressure applied on z axis. So this is a resistive touch screen in which pressure applied on the screen will accordingly change the resistance value, which in turn changes the p-point z value. After confirming the touch, we will map the p-point x and p-point y values and check these coordinates. If it is in the upper half, then we will set LED state as true, representing LED as on. Otherwise, set it to false. And finally, we will print the status. Now let's upload the code and check the output. Let's turn on the LED by clicking in the upper half. Then turn it off. We can see the LED status in the terminal window. Now I hope you have necessary information to create the user interface and read the touch coordinates to make your UI complete. So if you have a different variant of the screen or any other sensor module that you want to use, then I would recommend you to follow the same procedure that we did in this video. First, go through datasheet and find out how it works. Then search for some libraries or examples and take it as a reference to write your own code. So if you found this video helpful, then click on like button as well as share it with your friends. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button to get notified for upcoming video. Until then, take care. I'm your host VK, signing off.